Hello, good morning. Welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox One. This is my Vagabond Starship. And this is a very quick tutorial on something that... very basic. Very simple. And it's all to do with the oxygenation system in Space Engineers. I've been wanting to do a little tutorial on this for a while. What we have here is my little station area that I use to test things. My two-stage lockable airlock from the one video I did. And something new. To get right into this, I have built a small box attached to this, which can be oxygenated. And how I've done this, I wanted to show you some of the things that go wrong when you build in Space Engineers with an oxygen system. So, what we have here, very simple oxygen system. You need two things. You need your O2 H2 generator and some oxygen tanks, at least one or two, to store the oxygen, a couple of cargo boxes to store any ice that might be just waiting to be used by the system. And then I always use these conveyor blocks. The reason I use conveyor blocks rather than conveyor tubes is that a block is more versatile in that you can put one of these inside the wall of your ship or base and you can slap a air vent on it because you're going to need an air vent. You also might want an airlock. Now, a simple way to do an airlock, and I've shown this off in other videos, so you can find that, is to build two of these sliding doors like this, end to end, and you make an airlock. Now, you may notice that there is an issue straight away. We have no oxygen. O2 reads none. Why is this? It's because whilst this lovely generator here is airtight against the hull or the shell of your ship or base, this oxygen container is not. If we take a steel catwalk and we pop steel catwalks in, you'll see straight away that our air vents are producing oxygen and the room is oxygenated. So if you have one of these, situations, you can just put steel catwalk plates up on the wall like this, and you'll oxygenate your room. One of the things that I always stress when you're building in Space Engineers anyway, when you want to try and make an oxygenated room or put oxygen in your ship, is to think of your ship as several boxes. Now, I did this with the Century Eagle. I built that whole thing out as box after box, from stem to stern, as they say, starting with the bridge and then working back towards the reactor room. It wasn't pretty at all. I put the shell around it after I'd ensured it was completely airtight. It was a very simple design, but it avoided situations where you lost oxygen. Now, I am using a combination of creative mode tools and survival mode, because otherwise oxygenation doesn't actually work properly in creative. So if you're going to test this in creative, it won't give you the proper oxygen readings from the engine. So if you're using, like I did, a way to control certain things off the decompression within the air vent, it just won't work. But that's pretty much the oxygen system in a nutshell. If I wanted to build out an oxygen system into this room and I didn't want it under the floor, if it was in a ship, I would potentially put something along the lines of my favourite block, a conveyor junction into the wall. And if you want a quick and dirty way of doing it, pop a air vent on the side, and you can see why I like to use conveyor junction blocks because they're easy to link up. You're not messing with having to grind down tubes and rebuild them. You can just put them there and they will work. And they work quite well. If you wanted to, say, hide this vent a bit better, one thing you can do now, especially now we have access to the grated catwalks, is you could do what I've done on the floor here. So to do that, we now build our air vent in a recess like this. Make sure it's working. Decompress the room. Yeah, one yellow light. Four green. Get your grated catwalk. Decide which way you want it to turn. Pop it on the wall. You might have a bit of a gap, depending. I've used these windows. If that was the side of a starship and it was just blocks, like this. And if you're wondering how I'm doing all these buildings, I'm using line mode, which is found by tapping in the right stick when you have a block selected and moving across onto the build menu and toggle multi-block building. Make sure it's set to line, confirm it. But you can see this creates a fairly neat grated effect, like I've done on the floor. And you still have your workable airlock. You still have your air coming into the ship or the base. And that's really everything that you need to know about building with an oxygen system in Space Engineers. If you're curious about the options that you have on your vent, there are two states on a vent in terms of the actions. If we go into the vent menu, and you could do this to open up either the control panel or just tap X on the control panel itself, push across to the right on the left stick until you highlight toggle block, and then bring the left stick down until you reach setup actions and press A. You'll see there are two blocks at the bottom of actions. You can set an action to when the airlock depressurizes, or the air vent, and an action to when it repressurizes. And that's basically what you can do. So you can use that to control something within a room that runs when the airlock doors open, all the air is sucked out, you can have something happen. Of course, if you built a little airlock like this, you'll only lose a tiny, tiny bit of oxygen as you leave. Whereas with my complex airlock, you actually don't lose any oxygen. You can't get into this station at all. The door's locked until you cycle the airlock. Once you start cycling the airlock, the inner door will seal. The outer door will open. You'll always lose some oxygen from this system. And it's all down to timer blocks. And what I've done on this airlock here, if you look at the actions, that the rotating light turns off when the airlock is pressurized, and when it's depressurized, it turns the rotating light on. The timer blocks handle the rest. If you've seen my timer block tutorial, then you'll know how to set those up. Just as a refresher, this is what you could do with timer blocks. Each one triggers the next one in the line. And finally, I leave you with this. So, as always, stay safe, take care, have fun. Happy engineering till the next one. I'll see you on the flip side. Bye for now.